There are a lot of new treatments to help with colon cancer, all the way from prevention through treatment and beyond. When we talk about prevention of colon cancer, we're talking about how do we prevent it from growing in the first place. There are some studies actually out there looking at chemo prevention. When we talk about chemo prevention, we mean what medicines can you use ahead of time to help delay or put down the growth of colon cancer. Some of the newer studies are looking at vitamins such as vitamin D, calcium, to see if it can actually delay or decrease the amount of colon cancers that are out there. There is some evidence that shows this may actually decrease the incidence, but the data on that is still pretty immature, and we can't base any scientific knowledge on that yet. We also look at something called Crestor, or some of the lipid-lowering agents. These drugs have actually been shown in smaller studies to show that there's a decreased amount of polyps in patients' colons who are actually taking this medication. So there is a larger scale study looking at Crestor or the lipid-lowering agents to see if this can be predictive or help preventing colon cancer in the future. After chemo prevention, we then can look at some of the newer treatments for surgery. If you are diagnosed with a colon cancer, are there any newer surgical treatments? One of the newer modalities, if you will, on how we approach colon cancer is we understand the anatomy better now than we did, say, 10 or even 20 years ago. We know now that if you take out a certain number of lymph nodes, and for colon cancer that number would be 12, within the surgical specimen, we have a better chance of predicting the stage of the colon cancer and how you're going to do in the future. There are other techniques or newer techniques that have been established using laparoscopic surgery. Laparoscopic surgery is essentially minimally invasive surgery with small incisions and instruments that can do the surgery inside the abdomen without large incisions, which increases the patient's recovery, allows them to get out of the hospital faster, and it hasn't shown to be any difference in the terms of the cancer outcome. Not only do we have laparoscopic, but we also have robotic, and the robotic instrument has been able to help us operate in tighter spaces and do more inside the abdomen than we could with laparoscopic alone. After the surgical realm, we then move into the treatments afterwards. Some of the newer treatments in terms of the chemotherapy, we're looking at new drugs in the chemotherapy regimens that are being studied by certain drug companies. We're looking at drugs that have been used for other cancers that we're now trying within colon cancer. We're trying newer combinations to see if there's better effectiveness in treating the colon cancer. We're looking at targeted therapies. Now, targeted therapies is a newer class of drug that we're actually using currently in the metastatic setting, meaning where cancer has already spread, but now we're trying to look at that in what's called the adjuvant, or after you've been treated for the colon cancer, can we prevent it from coming back? So we are breaking new ground on a lot of the treatments. It's exciting where we're going to, and there's probably going to be a lot more treatments ahead that we can still look forward to.
For an interactive tool to learn more about your colon cancer and your personalized treatment options, go to mycoloncancercoach.org.